Hello everyone, I'm Noelia and today I'd like to introduce you to our airlock. Airlocks, also known as blow-off or spunding valve, are valves that allow us to regulate the pressure inside the fermenter. It's important to clarify that although they work as a relief valve, this valve should not substitute the use of a safety valve under any circumstances. The advantages of using this product are mainly two. First, as it is not a CO2-free vent, it allows us to preserve a greater aroma, which may be crucial depending on the type of beer. Second, being able to regulate the pressure inside the tank allows us to preserve CO2, which represents a saving both in economic terms and in carbonation time. The airlock must be connected in a vertical position, and the supply pipe must come out of the upper part of the tank. Once installed, we must fill the glass with water. This will allow us to see the generation of CO2 during the fermentation process. At the beginning of the fermentation, it is advisable not to vent CO2 through the airlock due to the large amount of CO2 that is generated, but to use another valve that purges into a bucket or container with water. From the second or third day on, we can perform the venting through the airlock. If we don't do it this way, pressure may end up building up inside the fermenter. Once we decide to start accumulating CO2, we must regulate the opening pressure of the airlock using the valve scale. To increase the pressure inside the fermenter, we should turn the valve clockwise, whereas we should do it counterclockwise to decrease it. We must always contrast the measure indicated by the scale with the pressure indicated in the pressure gauge. This is very important considering the scale may have a margin of error of up to 0.1 bar. Finally, the airlock also allows us to release pressure manually by pulling on the sphere placed in the valve. For washing, it is recommended to remove the airlock from the installation. The water in the glass must be replaced weekly. You should not fill the glass with alcohol or peracetic acid. The best is tap water. If the airlock is not being used, you should remove the glass and store it in a safe place. The pressure gauge must also be sanitized when it has been disassembled, always avoiding direct contact with the membrane. To conclude, it is important to comment that although the glass is a fragile product, we have spare parts in permanent stock, both for the acrylic and for gaskets and pressure gauges. Finally, remember that you can place your orders through our online shop or you can also contact one of our sales representatives.